A legitimate pawnbroker.
We've gotten some reports of increased loan sharking activities in your area.
Why would I know anything?
Well, I mean, you do have a history of making loans at rather whimsical interest rates.
I don't force anybody to do business with me. They come to see me because the banks and the finance companies won't touch them.
I see.
You know, I get a lot of you people.
Pardon me?
Cops. They're always coming in and pawning guns, gold badges, anything to get some money. Nice rings.
Nick, didn't I ask you to do something about that board?
Yeah, but you didn't specify.
I think what I had in mind was putting it in some sort of rational order. I mean, look at it. There are suspects up there we captured 2 years ago. Memos out of date, one circular covering another. Look at that.
I like to think of it as a collage.
Just take care of it.
Oh, Barney? I got Nicholas Della Rosa. He owns that pawn shop over on 14th. Claims he's completely unaware of any loan shark activities.
Della Rosa. Della Rosa.
I am a law-abiding member of the merchant's community.
Of course. Wasn't it last year that Mr. Della Rosa was arrested for receiving stolen merchandise?
Mm-hmm.
Now, look, I try to check. People bring me things. I ask them, you didn't steal that, did you? They say no. What more can I do?
Oh, conscientious.
Yeah, I got it. Barn?
Yep.
Disturbance over in Lexington.
All right, you and Dietrich.
Am I free to go now?
Do we have any further need of Mr. Della Rosa's presence?
Nah, Barn, we know where to find him.
Thank you for coming down, Mr. Della Rosa. We really appreciate your cooperation.
My pleasure. Look forward to seeing you both real soon. Lovely watch.
Jewelry fetish.
That's what you are.
You are a creature.
Well,
all right. There's no need to indulge in name calling.
Okay, what do we got?
Got a couple of bozos here. They're fighting over on Lexington. George Willis, Leo Fallon.
He was trying to mutilate my body.
I was trying to give him a piece of art, a thing of beauty.
Such as?
Tattoo.
Mr. Fallon here runs a tattoo parlor over this porno shop.
I told you, it's a studio.
Who cares?
Apparently, Mr. Willis was in the middle of getting a tattoo when he had second thoughts.
And he wouldn't take it off.
These are not decals, buddy.
When he first started doing it, I just had no idea how disgusting this thing really is. I mean, look at that.
Moth?
Well, there's supposed to be an ER on it, you know?
I figured out for myself. Thank you very much. What about the assault thing? Who's charging?
It's mutual.
All right, Dietrich, you want to take Mr.
Mr. Willis, have a seat over here.
Yeah, Mr. Fallon, sit over there.
Thank you.
With confiscated his dyes and the needles.
Artistic repression.
I told you, tattooing is illegal in New York City.
A tattoo is a work of art, and it's protected from laws, like a painting or a piece of sculpture.
Not in this town, it ain't.
And if you saw Michelangelo painting the creation, I suppose you'd arrest him, too.
If he was doing it on someone's body, yeah. Have a seat, Mr. Fallon. I'll be with you in a second. Saw so many guys in service get those things?
Yeah, I bet.
Paying some guy to burn a picture in your body. Now, that's sick.
Well, to each his own.
Pretty grotesque, right, Barn?
Well, I haven't really given it much thought.
I mean, if you think about it.
All right, if you insist, I will.
You will what?
Think about tattoos.
Oh. No, I...
Why don't you just tag this stuff for Joe?
See, that's the kind of guy that I am. I go whichever way the wind blows. Like, sometimes in the middle of the day, I'll jump on a bus and go right down to Atlantic City. Just like that.
Impetuous.
I know I look pretty conservative, but underneath all of this, I'm a pretty flaky guy. I just try and keep that a secret, that's all.
Occupation?
Accountant.
Good cover.
No, I want to put you in the cage now.
Where?
In the cage.
Oh.
You know something? You'd look great with an American Eagle across your chest.
No, thanks.
Oh, but girls love tattoos. Gives them something different to look at.
Yeah, I ain't had any complaints.
Nick, can't you do that outside?
It's illegal outside.
Barney? I went through the files and found some possible suspects who worked down on the docks, but nothing definite.
All right. Take a run down there, see what you can find out. Is that an opinion?
Oh, no, I was just bringing up some chalk.
Okay, I give up, Nick. Where'd you put the current arrest file?
Nick, we're out of coffee.
Hey, come on, Nick. No coffee.
Oh, really? I'm sure you'd love to have me make you some more. And I know you fellows want me to file your records for you. But as it happens, I'm gonna have a little lunch. I might have my shoes shine. I got a horse in the third race called Disco Danny. And I'm gonna put $20 right on his nose to commemorate the 20 years that I served on this force. And I'll be back later. And if the horse wins, possibly much later.
Uncharacteristic behavior.
Usually never says more than two words.
Mojo, I'd say that pretty much was two words.
Harris still out?
Yeah.
Nick's not back yet either.
No. Guess he just got tired of being the one who had to do the piddly junk around here. Fixing the coffee, taking care of the roster board. Yesterday was his anniversary, too.
What anniversary?
20 years on the force.
Well, I would have appreciated if someone had told me.
20 years ago yesterday.
Thank you.
Welcome. Finished tagging the tattoo stuff.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
November 2nd, 1993. In case I'm still here.
I'll make a note of that on my calendar.
It's a strange custom, tattooing.
Yeah.
Some people consider it an atavistic reversion to an earlier primitive state. Others submit to it because of peer pressure. There's probably other reasons I haven't thought of. I seem to be carrying on the bulk of this conversation. It's okay, I'm used to it. All my life I had to, I don't mind. Well, I'm gonna go check those guys for priors. Good idea.
All right, come on, inside here, Turner.
Man, what are you asking me for? I'm just trying to keep off welfare.
Very commendable.
This is our loan shark?
Yeah, it's one of them, Barney. Leland Turner, age 14.
14. I'm Captain Miller, Turner.
Hey, man, everybody gonna be honkies from now on?
Probably. Barney, I spoke to a couple of the dock workers, and Master Turner's name came up in a number of the conversations. I found him down near Pier 70, waving this pipe at a wino.
Well, look, he missed two payments. What would you do?
He was also carrying this. It's just over $7,000.
$7,000?
Disgusting, isn't it?
Look, those are my operating funds. I want a receipt for that.
Get a preliminary statement, see if you can find his family.
Okay, Junior, come on, have a seat over there.
Oh, man, what about my phone call?
You don't get one.
What about my lawyer?
You don't get one.
I'm afraid as a juvenile, you have very few rights, Mr. Turner.
Well, then what do I get?
An ice cream cone, if you're very nice.
Hey, Mr. Harris, try that with the ice cream cone.
Kids, they say the darndest things. Oh, well, hi, Nick.
Hi, Harris. Well, I'm back.
Nick, if you'd care to talk, I'd...
Hold his calls.
I guess you can't blame you cops for being the way you are when you gotta live like this.
Full name?
Muhammad X.
What happened to Turner?
That's a slave name. You can have it. Mine's Muhammad X.
How do you spell that?
X.
Thank you.
So this is it, huh?
This is what?
The office.
Come on, you've been here before.
Just briefly. It's not like Wojo and Harris, they spend the better part of the day here.
Because your conduct never required it.
Up till now.
Nick, I swear, if I knew that yesterday was 20 years, I...
No. That's not it. What I want is my contribution to this squad is recognized and respected.
Come on, you know I depend on you for 100 different things.
Coffee, filing, spring cleaning.
Yeah. But also for your experience, your sense of humor that gets us through the day, your composure.
Won't you mention once in a while?
All right, I will.
You know I wasn't coming back here today.
Why did you?
Mostly because I felt a sort of special obligation to you on account of all the time we've worked together and the high regard I have for you.
Thank you.
And besides, Disco Danny blew it in the stretch.
Address?
I have a number of residences.
Wherever you're wintering.
546 East 23rd.
So where your parents live?
Nah.
Where can I reach your father?
Try calling Attica. Anytime between 9 a.m. and 1981.
What about your mother?
This time of day, I'd say you could find her around 44th and Broadway. Hey, look, don't go sighing for me, brother. I got $7,000 sitting in that safe. You got $7,000? I got a Lincoln Continental. You got one?
Nah, they guzzle gas.
So level with me, man. What are you pulling? $20,000 a year?
I don't think that's any of your concern. Place of birth?
Less than that, huh?
Hey, look, I need your place of birth.
$18,000.
Look, Junior, I'm asking the questions here.
Born in Newark.
$16,000?
$23,000.
Thank you.
Hey, is that including bribes?
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Fallon had some previous citations for the parlor. Other than that, they're both clean.
All right. Just relax, Nick. Gentlemen, Sergeant Dietrich informs me that you both have relatively spotless records.
Of course.
Well, as soon as we issue another citation for your parlor, Mr. Fallon, it would appear to me that both of you could leave. Were not for the outstanding assault charges.
I'll forget it if you'll just get this thing off.
How many times do I have to tell you? They don't come off. Of course, there are methods to remove them.
Oh, yeah?
Sure. Tell it.
Well, a tattoo can be treated with acid, usually carbolic or sulfuric.
Hey, you want to burn it off?
There must be another way.
Well, it's surgery. Partial incision to fold back the flap of the skin and scrape the ink from the tissue.
Oh, my God.
The tattoo can simply be sliced off and removed.
All right, Dietrich, I think we understand the alternatives.
Could you see you're upsetting Mr. Willis?
Sorry if I was unduly graphic.
Listen, maybe I'll just keep it, okay?
Fine. Mr. Fallon, what about you?
He wants to walk around the rest of his life with moth on his arm. Okay with me.
All right, write him up, turn him loose.
Right. Barn, I finished processing Turner. The wino wasn't really injured, so I figured I'd call it assault, too. The DA will probably recommend family court.
Whatever you think is best.
Neither of his parents is exactly available, so I'm going to run him up to Spofford.
Fine.
What gets me, Barn, is Turner. I mean, he's not a stupid kid. He's just a smart-mouthed little kid who could go either way.
Reminds you a little of yourself at his age, huh?
No, Barney.
Oh, well, I meant...
I was always as you see me now.
Thank you, Barney.
What are you staring at, Honky?
Honky? That has an interesting etymology. It was coined by blacks in the 1950s in reference to the nasal tone of Caucasians.
Hey, man, don't mess with me, all right?
Okay, let's go, Turner.
You talking to me?
Yeah. We're taking a trip up to the Bronx.
Oh, I'm going to Spofford, huh?
You familiar with the accommodations?
Yeah, man, I was there last year for about half a second.
Now, Turner, you didn't get $7,000 being stupid. I mean, you got something going for you up here.
So?
So you got a chance to get out, a chance to make something good out of your life. Man, you're not gonna do it this way.
Hey, you want to drive my Continental? You know, give yourself a thrill, brother.
Hey, listen to me, you little twerp. What good is your car and your money when you're doing time in the slammer?
Yeah, well, that's better than sucking up 9 to 5 to some whitey.
Hey, listen. I don't suck up to anybody.
Well, you gotta suck up, because if you don't, they don't throw you your bread. A child who ain't got his own, he ain't nothing.
I don't care what you think of me or what I do, but you are headed nowhere fast.
And you still got nothing.
I may not have money, but I got something that you will never have.
Oh, yeah? What's that?
Credit. You remember this short stuff. You are just another loser until you can sign for something with D.
dignity.
Come on, move out. Come on.
Made some coffee.
Oh, yeah?
Try a cup?
Sure.
You know, sometimes people work together for a long time, and they never ever say how they really feel.
Yeah. No sugar.
Right. So I want you to know that I feel really lucky to be working with you. I mean it. I learn a lot from it.
Thanks.
Here goes. Not too good, huh?
All these years I thought it was me.
Here you can both go.
More.
You're stuck with it now.
Hey, I could finish it.
Finish it?
And outline it in magenta. It'll look fantastic.
I don't know. And anyway, they've got all your needles.
I got some old needles at the studio.
Okay, but just a quick ER.
Okay. So what if they're not electric?
Vaughn, would you like to try some Polish coffee?
Oh. You want me to get rid of this stuff, Vaughn?
Yeah, sure.
Pretty good.
Welcome back, Nick.
I bet one of these things hurts.
A little? I got a tattoo.
Well, we were 15 years old. It was VE Day. Just celebrating.
A few beers too many, you know.
I see.
Well, I'm not about to sit around feeling guilty about it 30 years later.
It would seem counterproductive to say the least.
The least.
Where'd you get it?
Asbury Park.
Oh, I mean, where?
Oh, under there.
What's it say?
Just a V and an E. Little rose under it.
Very tasteful.
You know, you had to appreciate the atmosphere, the excitement, the camaraderie. You know, the war was over. We just wanted to do something to remember it, you know?
Yeah, right.
All right, before we close the subject forever, are there any other questions?
Did you get one for VJ Day? Me neither.
Looking at?
Oh, looking at some old pictures. That's my graduation picture from the academy.
Hey. Which one are you?
I'm the one in the back. No, on the right side. Behind the plants.
All right.
You know, it was 20 years ago yesterday I became a cop.
Hey, congratulations.
That's okay, it was yesterday.
I guess you must have a lot of great memories and anecdotes, honey.
Oh, yeah, sure.
Now, listen, I'm a legitimate pawnbroker.
We've gotten some reports of increased loan sharking activities in your area.
Why would I know anything?
Well, I mean, you do have a history of making loans at rather whimsical interest rates.
I don't force anybody to do business with me. They come to see me because the banks and the finance companies won't touch them.
I see.
You know, I get a lot of you people.
Pardon me?
Cops. They're always coming in, pawning guns, gold badges, anything to get some money. Nice rings.
Nick, didn't I ask you to do something about that board?
Yeah, but you didn't specify.
I think what I had in mind was putting it in some sort of rational order. I mean, look at it. There are suspects up there we captured 2 years ago. Memos out of date, one circular covering another. Look at that.
I like to think of it as a collage.
Just take care of it.
Oh, Barney? I got Nicholas Della Rosa. He owns that pawn shop over on 14th. Claims he's completely unaware of any loan shark activities.
Della Rosa. Della Rosa.
I am a law-abiding member of the merchant's community.
Of course. Wasn't it last year that Mr. Della Rosa was arrested for receiving stolen merchandise?
Mm-hmm.
Now, look, I try to check. People bring me things. I ask them, you didn't steal that, did you? They say no. What more can I do?
Oh, conscientious.
Yeah, I got it. Barn? Yep. Disturbance over in Lexington?
All right, you and Dietrich.
Am I free to go now?
Do we have any further need of Mr. Delarosa's presence?
Nah, Barn, we know where to find him.
Thank you for coming down, Mr. Della Rosa. We really appreciate your cooperation.
My pleasure. Look forward to seeing you both real soon. Lovely watch.
Jewelry fetish.
That's what you are.
You are a creature.
Well,
All right. There's no need to indulge in name calling.
Okay, what do we got?
Got a couple of bozos here. They're fighting over on Lexington. George Willis, Leo Fallon.
He was trying to mutilate my body.
I was trying to give him a piece of art, a thing of beauty.
Such as?
Tattoo.
Mr. Fallon here runs a tattoo parlor over this porno shop.
I told you, it's a studio.
Who cares? Apparently, Mr. Willis was in the middle of getting a tattoo when he had second thoughts.
And he wouldn't take it off.
These are not decals, buddy.
When you first started doing it, I just had no idea how disgusting this thing really is. I mean, look at that.
Moth?
Well, there's supposed to be an ER on it, you know?
I figured out for myself. Thank you very much. What about the assault thing? Who's charging?
It's mutual.
All right, Dietrich, you want to take Mr.
All right, Mr. Willis, have a seat over here.
Yeah, Mr. Fallon, sit over there.
Thank you.
We confiscated his dyes and needles.
Artistic repression.
I told you, tattooing is illegal in New York City.
A tattoo is a work of art, and it's protected from laws, like a painting or a piece of sculpture.
Not in this town, it ain't.
Yeah, and if you saw Michelangelo painting the creation, I suppose you'd arrest him, too.
If he was doing it on someone's body, yeah. Have a seat, Mr. Fallon. I'll be with you in a second. Saw so many guys in service get those things?
Yeah, I bet.
Paying some guy to burn a picture in your body. Now, that's sick.
Well, to each his own.
Pretty grotesque, right, Barn?
Well, I haven't really given it much thought.
I mean, if you think about it.
All right, if you insist, I will.
You will what?
Think about tattoos.
Oh. No,
why don't you just tag this stuff for Joe?
See, that's the kind of guy that I am. I go whichever way the wind blows. Like sometimes in the middle of the day, I'll jump on a bus and go right down to Atlantic City. Just like that.
Impetuous.
I know I look pretty conservative, but underneath all of this, I'm a pretty flaky guy. I just try and keep that a secret, that's all.
Occupation?
Accountant.
Good cover.
No, I want to put you in the cage now.
Where?
In the cage.
Oh. You know something? You'd look great with an American eagle across your chest.
No, thanks.
Oh, but girls love tattoos. Gives them something different to look at.
Yeah, I ain't had any complaints.
Nick, can't you do that outside?
It's illegal outside.
Barney? I went through the files and found some possible suspects who work down on the docks, but nothing definite.
All right. Take a run down there, see what you can find out. Is that an opinion?
Oh, no, I was just bringing up some chalk.
But my lawyer.
You don't get one.
I'm afraid as a juvenile, you have very few rights, Mr. Turner.
Well, then what do I get?
An ice cream cone, if you're very nice.
Hey, Mr. Harris. Try that with the ice cream cone.
Kids, they say the darndest things. Oh, well, hi, Nick.
Hi, Harris. Well, I'm back.
Nick, if you'd care to talk, I'd...
Hold his calls.
I guess you can't blame you cops for being the way you are when you gotta live like this.
Full name?
Muhammad X.
What happened to Turner?
That's a slave name. You can have it. Mine's Muhammad X.
How do you spell that?
X.
Thank you.
So this is it, huh?
This is what?
The office.
Come on, you've been here before.
Just briefly. It's not like Wojo and Harris, they spend the better part of the day here.
Because your conduct never required it.
Up till now.
Nick, I swear, if I knew that yesterday was 20 years,
No. That's not it. What I want is, my contribution to this squad is recognized and respected.
Come on, you know I depend on you for 100 different things.
Coffee, filing, spring cleaning.
Yeah. But also for your experience, your sense of humor that gets us through the day, your composure.
Why don't you mention once in a while?
Right. I will.
You know I wasn't coming back here today.
Why did you?
Mostly because I felt a sort of special obligation to you on account of all the time we've worked together and the high regard I have for you.
Thank you.
And besides, Disco Danny blew it in the stretch.
Address?
I have a number of residences.
Wherever you're wintering.
546 East 23rd.
So where your parents live?
Nah.
Where can I reach your father?
Try calling Attica. Anytime between 9 a.m. and 1981.
What about your mother?
This time of day, I'd say you could find her around 44th and Broadway. Hey, look, don't go sighing for me, brother. I got $7,000 sitting in that safe. You got $7,000? I got a Lincoln Continental. You got one?
Nah, they guzzle gas.
So level with me, man. What are you pulling? $20,000 a year?
I don't think that's any of your concern. Place of birth?
Less than that, huh?
Hey, look, I need your place of birth.
$18,000.
Look, Junior, I'm asking the questions here.
Born in Newark.
$16,000?
$23,000. Not bad.
Thank you.
Hey, hey. Is that including bribes?
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Fallon had some previous citations for the parlor. Other than that, they're both clean.
All right. Just relax, Nick. Gentlemen, Sergeant Dietrich informs me that you both have relatively spotless records.
Of course.
Well, as soon as we issue another citation for your parlor, Mr. Fallon, it would appear to me that both of you could leave. If it were not for the outstanding assault charges.
I'll forget it if you'll just get this thing off.
How many times do I have to tell you? They don't come off.
Of course, there are methods to remove them.
Oh, yeah?
Sure. Tell it.
Well, a tattoo can be treated with acid, usually carbolic or sulfuric.
Hey, you want to burn it all?
There must be another way.
Well, it's surgery. Partial incision to fold back the flap of the skin and scrape the ink from the tissue.
Oh, my God.
The tattoo can simply be sliced off and removed.
All right, Dietrich, I think we understand the alternatives.
Can't you see you're upsetting, Mr. Willis?
Sorry if I was unduly graphic.
Listen, maybe I'll just keep it, okay?
Fine. Mr. Fallon, what about you?
He wants to walk around the rest of his life with moth on his arm. Okay with me.
All right, write him up, turn him loose.
Thank you. Right. Barn, I finished processing Turner. The wino wasn't really injured, so I figured I'd call it assault, too. The DA will probably recommend family court.
Whatever you think is best.
Neither of his parents is exactly available, so I'm going to run him up to Spofford.
Fine.
What gets me, Barn, is Turner. I mean, he's not a stupid kid. He's just a smart-mouthed little kid who could go either way.
Reminds you a little of yourself at his age, huh?
No, Barney.
Oh, well, I meant...
I was always as you see me now.
Thank you, Barney.
What are you staring at, Honky?
Honky?
That has an interesting etymology. It was coined by blacks in the 1950s in reference to the nasal tone of Caucasians.
Hey, man, don't mess with me, all right?
Okay, let's go, Turner.
You talking to me?
Yeah. We're taking a trip up to the Bronx.
Oh, I'm going to Spofford, huh?
You familiar with the accommodations?
Yeah, man. I was there last year for about half a second.
No, Turner. You didn't get $7,000 being stupid. I mean, you got something going for you up here.
So?
So you got a chance to get out. A chance to make something good out of your life. Man, you're not gonna do it this way.
Hey, you wanna drive my Continental? You know, give yourself a thrill, brother.
Hey, listen to me, you little twerp. What good is your car and your money when you're doing time in the slammer?
Yeah, well, that's better than sucking up 9 to 5 to some whitey.
Hey, listen. I don't suck up to anybody.
Well, you gotta suck up, because if you don't, they don't throw you your bread. A child who ain't got his own, he ain't nothing.
I don't care what you think of me or what I do, but you are headed nowhere fast.
And you still got nothing.
I may not have money, but I got something that you will never have.
Oh, yeah? What?
Okay, I give up, Nick. Where'd you put the current arrest file?
Nick, we're out of coffee.
Hey, come on, Nick.
No coffee.
Oh, really? I'm sure you'd love to have me make you some more. And I know you fellows want me to file your records for you. But as it happens, I'm gonna have a little lunch. I might have my shoes shine. I get a horse in the third race called Disco Danny, and I'm gonna put $20 right on his nose to commemorate the 20 years that I served on this force. And I'll be back later. And if the horse wins, possibly much later.
Uncharacteristic behavior.
Usually never says more than two words.
Mojo, I'd say that pretty much was two words.
Harris still out?
Yeah.
Nick's not back yet either.
No.
Guess he just got tired of being the one who had to do the piddly junk around here. Fixing the coffee, taking care of the roster board. Yesterday was his anniversary, too.
What anniversary?
20 years on the force.
Well, I would have appreciated if someone had told me.
It's 20 years ago yesterday.
Thank you.
Welcome. Finished tagging the tattoo stuff. You're welcome.
November 2nd, 1993. In case I'm still here.
I'll make a note of that on my calendar.
It's a strange custom, tattooing.
Yeah.
Some people consider it an atavistic reversion to an earlier primitive state. Others submit to it because of peer pressure. Probably other reasons I haven't thought of. I seem to be carrying on a bulk of this conversation. It's okay, I'm used to it. All my life I had to, I don't mind. Well, I'm gonna go check those guys for priors. Good idea.
All right, come on, inside here, Turner.
Man, what are you hassling me for? I'm just trying to keep off welfare.
Very commendable.
This is our loan shark?
Yeah, it's one of them, Barney. Leland Turner, age 14.
14. I'm Captain Miller, Turner.
Hey, man. Everybody gonna be honkies from now on?
Probably. Barney, I spoke to a couple of the dock workers, and Master Turner's name came up in a number of the conversations. I found him down near Pier 70. Waving this pipe at a wino.
Well, look, he missed two payments. What would you do?
He was also carrying this. It's
just over $7,000.
$7,000?
Disgusting, isn't it?
Look, those are my operating funds. I want a receipt for that.
Get a preliminary statement, see if you can find his family.
Okay, Junior, come on, have a seat over there.
Oh, man, what about my phone call?
You don't get one.
What's he looking at?
Oh, looking at some old pictures. That's my graduation picture from the academy.
Hey. Which one are you?
I'm the one in the back. No, on the right side. Behind the plants.
All right.
You know, it was 20 years ago yesterday I became a cop.
Hey, congratulations.
That's okay, it was yesterday.
I guess you must have a lot of great memories and anecdotes, honey.
Oh, yeah, sure.
Now, listen, I'm a legitimate pawnbroker.
We've gotten some reports of increased loan sharking activities in your area.
Why would I know anything?
Well, I mean, you do have a history of making loans at rather whimsical interest rates.
I don't force anybody to do business with me. They come to see me because the banks and the finance companies won't touch them.
I see.
You know, I get a lot of you people.
Pardon me?
Cops. They're always coming in, pawning guns, gold badges, anything to get some money. Nice rings.
Nick, can I ask you to do something about that board?
Yeah, but you didn't specify.
I think what I had in mind was putting it in some sort of rational order. I mean, look at it. There are suspects up there we captured 2 years ago. Memos out of date, one circular covering another. Look at that.
I like to think of it as a collage.
Just take care of it.
Barney? I got Nicholas Della Rosa. He owns that pawn shop over on 14th. Claims he's completely unaware of any loan shark activities.
Della Rosa. Della Rosa.
I am a law-abiding member of the merchant's community.
Of course. Wasn't it last year that Mr. Della Rosa was arrested for receiving stolen merchandise?
Mm-hmm.
Now, look, I try to check. People bring me things. I ask them. You didn't steal that, did you? They say no. What more can I do?
Oh, conscientious.
Yeah, I got it. Barn? Yeah. Disturbance over in Lexington.
All right, you and Dietrich.
Am I free to go now?
Do we have any further need of Mr. Delarosa's presence?
Nah, Barn, we know where to find him.
Thank you for coming down, Mr. Della Rosa. We really appreciate your cooperation.
My pleasure. Look forward to seeing you both real soon. Lovely watch.
Jewelry fetish.
Thank you. right.
Butcher, that's what you are.
And you are a creature.
Well, let me
All right, there's no need to indulge in name calling.
Okay, what do we got?
Got a couple of bozos here. They're fighting over on Lexington. George Willis, Leo Fallon.
He was trying to mutilate my body.
I was trying to give him a piece of art, a thing of beauty.
Such as?
Tattoo.
Mr. Fallon here runs a tattoo parlor over this porno shop.
I told you, it's a studio.
Who cares? Apparently, Mr. Willis was in the middle of getting a tattoo when he had second thoughts.
And he wouldn't take it off.
These are not decals, buddy.
When he first started doing it, I just had no idea how disgusting this thing really is. I mean, look at that.
Moth?
Well, there's supposed to be an ER on it, you know?
I figured it out for myself. Thank you very much. What about the assault thing? Who's charging?
It's mutual.
All right, Dietrich, you want to take Mr.
Mr. Willis, have a seat over here.
Yeah, Mr. Fallon, sit over there.
Thank you.
We confiscated his dyes and needles.
Artistic repression.
I told you, tattooing is illegal in New York City.
A tattoo is a work of art, and it's protected from laws, like a painting or a piece of sculpture.
Not in this town, it ain't.
Yeah, and if you saw Michelangelo painting the creation, I suppose you'd arrest him, too.
If he was doing it on someone's body, yeah. Have a seat, Mr. Fallon. I'll be with you in a second. So many guys in service get those things?
Yeah, I bet.
Paying some guy to burn a picture in your body. Now, that's sick.
Well, to each his own.
Pretty grotesque, right, Barn?
Well, I haven't really given it much thought.
I mean, if you think about it.
All right, if you insist, I will.
You will what?
Think about tattoos.
Oh. No, I...
Why don't you just tag the stuff, Wojo?
See, that's the kind of guy that I am. I go whichever way the wind blows. Like, sometimes in the middle of the day, I'll jump on a bus and go right down to Atlantic City. Just like that.
Impetuous.
I know I look pretty conservative, but underneath all of this, I'm a pretty flaky guy. I just try and keep that a secret, that's all.
Occupation?
Accountant.
Good cover.
No, I want to put you in the cage now.
Where?
In the cage.
Oh. You know something? You'd look great with an American eagle across your chest.
No, thanks.
Oh, but girls love tattoos. Gives them something different to look at.
Yeah, I ain't had any complaints.
Nick, can't you do that outside?
It's illegal outside.
Barney? I went through the files and found some possible suspects who work down on the docks, but nothing definite.
All right. Take a run down there, see what you can find out. Is that an opinion?
Oh, no, I was just bringing up some chalk.
Okay, I give up, Nick. Where'd you put the current arrest file?
Nick, we're out of coffee.
Hey, come on, Nick.
No coffee.
Oh, really? I'm sure you'd love to have me make you some more. And I know you fellows want me to file your records for you. But as it happens, I'm going to have a little lunch. I might have my shoes shine. I get a horse in the third race called Disco Danny. And I'm going to put $20 right on his nose to commemorate the 20 years that I served on this force. And I'll be back later. And if the horse wins, possibly much later.
Uncharacteristic behavior.
Usually never says more than two words.
Mojo, I'd say that pretty much was two words.
Harris still out?
Yeah.
Nick's not back yet either.
No.
Guess he just got tired of being the one who had to do the piddly junk around here. Fixing the coffee, taking care of the roster board. Yesterday was his anniversary, too.
What anniversary?
20 years on the force.
Well, I would have appreciated if someone had told me.
It's 20 years ago yesterday.
Thank you.
Welcome. Finished tagging the tattoo stuff.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
November 2nd, 1993. In case I'm still here.
I'll make a note of that on my calendar.
It's a strange custom, tattooing.
Yeah.
Some people consider it an atavistic reversion to an earlier primitive state. Others submit to it because of peer pressure. There's probably other reasons I haven't thought of. I seem to be carrying on the bulk of this conversation. It's okay, I'm used to it. All my life I had to, I don't mind. Well, I'm gonna go check those guys for priors. Good idea.
All right, come on, inside here, Turner.
Man, what are you hassling me for? I'm just trying to keep off welfare.
Very commendable.
This is our loan shark?
Yeah, it's one of them, Barney. Leland Turner, age 14.
14. I'm Captain Miller, Turner.
Hey, man. Everybody gonna be honkies from now on?
Probably. Barney, I spoke to a couple of the dock workers, and Master Turner's name came up in a number of the conversations. I found him down near Pier 70, waving this pipe at a wino.
Well, look, he missed two payments. What would you do?
He was also carrying this. It's just over $7,000.
$7,000?
Disgusting, isn't it?
Look, those are my operating funds. I want a receipt for that.
Get a preliminary statement, see if you can find his family.
Okay, Junior, come on, have a seat over there.
Oh, man, what about my phone call?
You don't get one.
What about my lawyer?
You don't get one.
I'm afraid as a juvenile, you have very few rights, Mr. Turner.
Well, then what do I get?
An ice cream cone, if you're very nice.
Hey, Mr. Harris. Try that with the ice cream cone.
Kids, they say the darndest things.
Sit down!
Oh, well, hi, Nick.
Hi, Harris. Well, I'm back.
Nick, if you'd care to talk, I'd...
Hold his calls.
I guess you can't blame you cops for being the way you are when you gotta live like this.
Full name?
Muhammad X.
What happened to Turner?
That's a slave name. You can have it. Mine's Muhammad X.
How do you spell that?
X.
Thank you.